I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey whippersnappers, Brian here at A Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip hop songs using lyric videos, and then I let you know what I thought about them. As you can see, I'm going to be reacting to Onion Head by Sean Price. And when I picked this one, I thought, I know the name Sean Price. I've reacted to something that Sean Price has been in, and I didn't want to duplicate a bio. So I went into my archives and saw that he was a member of Helta Skelta, Rock and Ruck. And I totally knew Rock and Ruck, the names, but I hadn't done any Helta Skelta songs, and finally figured out that they're in the Fab Five, and I did La Fleur, Eshkoshka. So that's how I know them. I'm not going to do any bio. If you want to hear the bio by them, go check out my I have a Boot Camp Click playlist. It'll be in there. Oh, and I know that Sean died, so RIP Sean. Okay. In 2000, Rock left Duck Down to pursue a solo career with DJ Lethal and his new label, Lethal Dose Records. However, that project folded. Price found himself in jail or back on the streets of Brooklyn, hustling and selling crack in order to survive. After a few years of hard times, he began appearing on various mixtapes, including Donkey Sean Jr. with P.F. Cutton, a mixtape featuring various freestyles intended as a precursor to his debut solo album. Price, who was knee-deep in the streets at the time, says his return to the rap game was fueled as much by a desire to become an upstanding citizen as it was to let his creativity run wild. He says, I got tired of getting arrested, man. You know, it's real hard when you rent a car, then you got two girls in the car ahead of you with drugs on them, and you in the other car making sure they get where they're going. Too much shit, man. I'm tired of that shit. That shit was cool when I was a teenager. I got kids now. When I did it before, it wasn't no worries. But now my kids and shit. My wife, she calling me every fucking minute. What's going on? What am I going to tell her? I'm selling crack. Unquote. What's the story about he's renting a car and he's buying two girls in a car with drugs? Let me know what that means, because I don't know what that means. He also appeared on albums as a solo artist using his birth name Sean Price. A notable guest appearance during this period was on Rising to the Top, a duo with Dipset affiliate Agala, that was featured in the popular video game Grand Theft Auto 3. A reinvigorated Duck Down Records in May 2005 announced their Triple Threat campaign, a three-album collaborative effort with a rap collective, The Justice League, and their in-house producers, Ninth Wonder and Crisis. Monkey Bars, Price's solo debut and the first installment of the campaign, was also released in May of 2005, attaining very favorable reviews. Rock made an appearance on Monkey Bars and joined Price on Smith & Wesson Reloaded. So they're still friends. Coinciding with Duck Down's resurgence was the rise of the Justice League collective, helmed by producer Ninth Wonder, who had struck a creative bond with Buckshot that served as a conduit between the two crews. One product of that alliance that's found on Monkey Bars comes in the form of Onion Head, which captures Price volleying menacing quips atop a soulful composition courtesy of Crisis. Dismantling the opposition, lyrically or otherwise, in a dismissive manner may be a pillar of Price's artistry, but on Monkey Bars, he's at his most endearing when he touches on the more mundane aspects of his life, such as being a father, disliking his wife's home-cooked meals. And his favorite pastimes. The singles from Monkey Bars are Rising to the Top. Oh, that's the one from the video game. Boom, Bye, Yeah, and Onion Head. Onion Head was produced by Crisis and features Tech. Oh, he's one half of Smith and Wesson. And they had to change their name, and they changed it to Coco Brothers, which is the worst name change ever. Did someone tell me, or did I ever figure out why they just didn't call themselves Tech and Steel? It's such a good title. Way better than Coco Brothers. Okay. Onion Head by Ruck, aka Sean Price. Oh, I couldn't find a lyric video, so I'm gonna scroll. Let's go, fucker. Huh? Stupid motherfuckers. Let's rhyme, like Brownsville. Yeah, felonious mug. Let's go. Yo, hey yo, bitch Harvey. This Swiss Army knife in my hand. Know this shit corny, but it can end the life of your fam. Niggas know Sean nice with the hands. Watch me punch up your face, dig in your pockets, leave you right where you stand. Got a Donna bitch that live in Japan. Black belt, suck dick, chop bricks with a hand. Arigato, Sean Price slick like El Gato. Three-piece suit in the booth, ain't shit cute. Might smack off half your smile. Go to court with a suit, smack the other half after trial. Plead the fifth, y'all niggas better plead the eighth. Don't leave your face fucked up, now your niece is rape. I'm bugging. Eat pills, mushrooms, and dust. Got that nigga Sean P in the mood to bust. Sean P, the motherfucking all-time great. New York, the NC, nigga, the all-round state. From coast to coast, he traveled the land. Left footprints and grains of sand. It's Sean P. Soldier force, the magnum deliver. In his presence, phony rappers a shiver. It's Sean P. Since now we're in the even 200. Lord help you if you got the stacked up and blooded. It's Sean P. Underrated. Best in the game. Allow me to tell these lying hands. Yo, what's your motherfuckers name? Motherfuckers ain't as nice as me. And if they is, they would've been Sean. That's fucked up for you. You should've been on. Grabbing the chin. Drunk rappers need to grab up a pen. Write some ill shit, nigga, then let the madness begin. Rhyming for dough. No money, Paul. Rhyming for dough. No partners, just me. Highlighting the show. Niggas said I lost my image when I cut off my dreads. But I'm the nicest nigga out, Duke. Fuck what you said. Let it be known. Gold ring embedded with stone. So when I punch you in the head, this shit will dent up your dome. Niggas running up, asking about rock. I'm sending your ass to heaven. Motherfucker, ask God about Pac. Ask about Big. Motherfucker, ask about Pun. Gangsta rappers can't fight, so they rap about guns. Run. From coast to coast, he traveled the land. Left footprints and grains of sand. It's Sean P. Soldier force, the magnum deliver. In his presence, phony rappers a shiver. It's Sean P. The sixth runway in the even 200. Lord help you if he got the stacked up and blooded. It's Sean P. Underrated. Best in the game. Allow me to tell these lying heads, what's your name? Sean P. First of all, let me look at something here. So in the thing I read, what did it say? On Monkey Bars, he's at his most endearing when he touches on the more mundane aspects of his life, such as being a father, disliking his wife's home-cooked meals, and his favorite pastimes. Well, maybe shooting people on the streets is one of his favorite pastimes, because this doesn't seem, you know, it doesn't seem very endearing. But that's neither here nor there. It's just funny because what I had read is not really what I heard, but that doesn't matter. So the song is Braggadocio. Sean's back. It had been a while since he had recorded, like an album, and especially solo. And I guess somewhere along the lines, he cut off his dreads, and people were laughing at him for that. But you don't want to laugh too hard at Sean P because he's 6'1" and 200 pounds, and he'll kill you. What is an onion head? Allow me to tell these onion heads what's your name. I don't know. Let me know what an onion head is. I don't know. So the chorus, I'm not a big fan of the "It's Sean P" call out. It didn't do anything for the chorus, as far as I'm concerned. It was, I'm all about, what's it called? Call and return? Or whatever that is, when someone yells out and someone yells something back. But "It's Sean P" did not do it for me. That shout. I would have liked something better, but always comes back to the chorus for me. He had a very forceful flow, deep voice, not endearing. But he sounds like and he looks like, you don't want to fuck with him, because he might do, one of his hobbies on you. And so they only use tech for the hook, huh? And he's good. I've done Smith and Wesson a couple times. This is going in my car because it is fun, but I don't dig the chorus with the with a "It's Sean P." It wasn't necessary. Thanks for hanging with you guys. If you like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe. I'll see you on the next video.